Hello all, myself Dr. M. Kadir Selvam, Asking Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at K.S. Rangaswamy College of Technology. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the relationship between stress and strain. So already in the previous video, we have discussed about that what is meant by stress and what is meant by strain. So the relationship between the stress and strain is developed by the Hooke's, based on the Hooke's law, we can term it as within the elastic limit, the stress will be directly proportional to the strain. So in order to remove the proportionality constant, we are using the constant called Young's modulus or modulus of elasticity. So for the one dimensional system, the stress by strain is equal to Young's modulus. Okay. So usually the component whatever we are using in our real time life application is of three dimensional. So in case of it is object is of two dimension, so there are two different types of strains we can calculate. So one is that longitudinal strain. The next one is the lateral strain. So let us assume a rectangular component. So in which we are going to apply the tensile load, that is the pulling load. So because of the pulling, its cross section will be reduced. Meanwhile, its length will be increased. So the change in dimension, that is increase in length to the original length, gives the longitudinal strain. Meanwhile, the diameter, if in case of a rod, otherwise the height or width in case of a rectangular section, it will be reduced. So that reduction, that this, the change in diameter or the change in width divided by the original diameter or width, is termed as lateral strain. Okay, in a two-dimensional system, we can able to measure this change in dimension in perpendicular directions. So therefore, one direction may be increased, meanwhile the other direction will be decreased. So that direction in the application of load will be called as longitudinal strain. The strain which is calculated in the direction perpendicular to the application of load is called lateral strain. So here it is increase in length by original length, it is longitudinal strain. Change in breadth or change in diameter by original breadth or diameter, it is called as lateral strain. So the next thing, so Poisson's ratio. So there may be some key term that relates the relationship between the longitudinal strain and lateral strain. So that is the Poisson's ratio. So Poisson's ratio, it is nothing but the ratio of the lateral strain to longitudinal strain. So the strain which is taking place in the direction perpendicular to the application of force divided by the strain which is actually taking place in the direction of the applied load is called Poisson's ratio. So it is also constant. Mostly for the engineering material, the Poisson's ratio will be maximum of 0.3. So beyond that, it will be not possible. So the maximum value of the Poisson's ratio will be 0.3. So it is usually denoted by the symbol mu. So the Poisson's ratio is equal to lateral strain by longitudinal strain. Okay. So the next one important is the sign convention. So as we already discussed in this slide, so whenever there is an increase in or change in dimension in one direction, so therefore we can also experience the decrease in the dimension in the counterclockwise counter direction. So therefore the decrease will be denoted in the always in the minus sign. Whenever we are experiencing some increment, that will be denoted in the positive. So wherever we are feeling or experiencing some decline, that is a decrease in diameter or decrease in volume, there we are using that minus sign. Therefore, so here the lateral strain will always be in the minus. So therefore, we are using that minus mu into longitudinal strain. So if we can able to calculate the longitudinal strain, it will be easy for us to calculate the lateral strain with the relationship formula mu into longitudinal strain. So we are introducing the negative sign because the value is decreased. So here the dimension is decreased, so we are using that minus sign. So for a three-dimensional system, so as I already discussed that Poisson's ratio, E1 is equal to E1 in the direction of applied force, E2 in the direction of 90 degree to the application of direct force, and again E3 in the again the remaining one dimension strain expression in the remaining one direction. Therefore, as I already told you that E1 is equal to E1 in the direction, so strain experienced in the direction 1 is equal to strain in the experienced in the length plus strain experienced in the breadth plus strain experienced in the maybe the height. Okay, these are the three different strains. First, we need to calculate the strain in the along the length direction. So it is given by the formula. As we already we know that stress by strain is equal to Young's modulus. So stress by strain is equal to Young's modulus. Equal to Young's modulus. Therefore, strain is given by stress by Young's modulus. Therefore, I can return for this strain in terms of L as that is the length direction as stress by Young's modulus in the length direction plus stress by Young's modulus in the breadth direction plus stress by Young's modulus in the height, that may be the thickness. So here it will be positive. Okay, so therefore I am using that sigma 1 by E1. Okay, here for the breadth wise it will decrease. Okay, it will decrease, so that I need to use that formula minus. So why I am using that mu means I am converting that, I am calculating the lateral strain from longitudinal strain. So therefore I need to multiply it with Poisson ratio. As it is the dimension is decreasing, I need to use that minus sign as well. So therefore I can simply written it as minus mu into sigma by E in second direction or in the breadthwise direction. Likewise, minus mu into sigma by E into in the direction of height, otherwise the third dimension. So likewise, I can able to estimate the strain experienced by three dimensional component. Okay, so sigma 1 by E minus mu into sigma 2 by E minus mu into sigma 3 by E. Likewise, for the other two dimensions also, we can directly calculate. For this breadthwise direction, we have to calculate, keep that strain in the breadth direction as positive and the other two as in the negative, as that two are in lateral strain when compared to that breadth. Okay, so likewise only we need to calculate. So the next one, final thing is that volumetric strain. So volumetric strain is nothing but the generic formula for the strain is change in change in dimension by original dimension. Meanwhile, in case of a volumetric strain, it is nothing but change in volume by original volume. Okay. Now, in case of a rectangular board, let us assume a rectangular board as shown in the figure of having the length L, breadth B, and the thickness D or height, whatever it may be. So we are applying a force of P. P is nothing but the tensile load which is acting towards the length. Okay. So the volume of the rectangular bar is length into breadth into height. So L into B into D. So after the application of force, that length will be increased by delta L. Meanwhile, the breadth will be decreased by delta B and depth will be decreased by delta D. So for the easy sign convention, I am using that minus sign. For the final, it will be written as plus sign. Finally, it will be converted into that minus sign because of the conversion of the lateral strain and longitudinal strain using Poisson's ratio. So therefore, final volume will be L plus delta L, B plus delta B, D plus delta D. So therefore, the change in increase in volume will be given by final volume by original volume. So L plus delta L, B plus delta B, D plus delta D minus L into B into D. So what we can get? So we need to multiply with each and every term. So therefore, it will be a large equation. So we can neglect the delta squares because even the delta will be very minimum value. So therefore, the delta square will be very, very minimum. So we can ignore all the delta square values. So the remaining value, it will be LBD minus BD into delta L plus LB into delta D plus LD into delta B. The simple formula is, simple thing to memorize is, if we are using the L behind the delta, we need to use other two terms, B into D. If we are using that D terms, we need to use other two terms behind the in front of the delta terms. So this is a shortcut to memorize the formula for delta V. So then the volumetric strain, in the as discussed in the previous slide, it is change in volume by original volume. So change in volume we have calculated, and the original volume is L into B into D. So the volumetric strain will be given as we can calculate BD BD. Therefore delta L by L plus delta B by B plus delta D by D. So this is the volumetric strain for the rectangular bar. Now I need to convert this into with the help of Poisson's ratio. Therefore, it will be easy for me with a single equation. I can able to call it. I don't need to measure that change in dimension in the breadth as well as depth. With the change in dimension in length, I can directly calculate the whole change in dimensions. Then how we can do? As we discussed in that previous, the lateral strain is given by minus mu into longitudinal strain. Here it is change. Here it may be diameter or it may sorry depth or it may be width. So with that, longitudinal strain is equal to plus 2 into lateral strain. So here instead of lateral strain, I can directly substitute minus 2 into mu into longitudinal strain. So therefore minus mu into longitudinal strain. If I substitute this, what I can get? Longitudinal strain plus 2 into bracket minus mu into longitudinal strain. I can take it the longitudinal strain in the common in the outside. Therefore the longitudinal strain into 1 minus 2 mu. Here as I am going to apply that force in the length direction, the longitudinal strain will be delta L by L. So therefore, I can able to calculate the total volumetric strain with the formula 1 minus 2 mu into delta L by L, where delta L is the increase in length, that is mainly in the direction of the application of the load. So L is the total length and mu is the Poisson's ratio of the material. Okay, so it will be easy if we can work out a problem. So let us see a problem. So here they told us the length of the steel bar is 300. Let us assume this same diagram. So the length is 300 mm, okay, and void is 50 mm and the thickness is 40 mm, okay. So they are applying a load of 300 kilonewton in the direction of length. As shown in the figure only, they are explaining. So they told us to calculate the change in volume. So how we can calculate the change in volume? Again, we need to implement the formula. Volumetric strain is equal to, what is the formula? Volumetric strain, it is denoted by the symbol EV is equal to what I can get? Delta L by L into 1 minus 2 mu. So delta L by L is nothing but the linear strain into 1 minus 2 mu. I hope that value of the Poisson's ratio is given in the formula. Okay. So first I need to find out the change in length. So the change in length, how I can calculate? Again, I can calculate the value of change in length with the stress strain relationship, otherwise that PL by AE formula. Okay, in the last video also we have discussed it. So therefore, how I can calculate? So delta L is equal to PL by AE. Delta L is equal to change in length. So therefore, change in length is equal to PL by AE. So P is nothing but load, L is length, AE is area of the cross-sectional area, and E is the Young's modulus. So what is the load applied here? It is 300 kilonewton. Therefore, it is 300 into 10 to the power of 3. Okay. So therefore, again, the length. So the length of this component is 300 mm. So therefore 300 divided by area. Area here it is cross sectional area. So in case of a rectangular bar, if I apply the load in the direction of length, the cross section is breadth into diameter. What is the breadth here? 50. Thickness it is 40. Not diameter, it is the height or depth. 50 into 40. So therefore, the area is 50 into 40 into Young's modulus. The value of Young's modulus is 2 into 10 to the power of 5. 2 into 10 to the power of 5 Newton per mm square. Just substitute or calculate all this value, and what we can get is the value of the increase in change in length. So it's not given here. We will calculate it directly. So so 300 into 10 to the power 3 into 300 divided by 50, 40, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. what you get? 0.225 mm. So actually the volumetric strain will be calculated with this formula. So directly substitute the value there, what we can get? So volumetric strain is equal to 0.225. The original length is 300. Into 1 minus 2 mu. 1 minus 2. What is the value of Poisson's ratio? The Poisson's ratio here it is 0.25. So after solving this equation, what we can get? The volumetric strain for the rectangular body is 0.000375. So this is the volumetric strain experienced in the rectangular bar. What they have told us to calculate? We need to calculate the change in volume. So therefore, the change in volume, can be given by, so volumetric strain into volume of the component. So into volume. How we derived this means? So volumetric strain is equal to change in volume by original volume. So I will make one more step so that it will not be confusing. Okay, now it will be easy for to understand. So therefore, I need to calculate the change in volume. So therefore, change in volume is equal to volumetric strain into original volume. So what is the original volume of the rectangular bar? Length into breadth into thickness. So its length is 300, breadth is 50 into 40. Just substitute all the value here. So what we can get is, so the change in dimension is, I think it is around 225 millimeter cube. So this is the total change in volume of the rectangular bar when it is subjected to a load of 300 kilonewton external force. Okay, so thank you all.